الصبح بدا من طلعته والليل دجى من وفرته
الله 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 الله.
A person becomes a murid with a Kamil Shaykh in order to become close to Allah, to know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala azza wa jal. But this does not just happen because you give your hand into the hand of a Kamil Shaykh. The first prerequisite being that the Shaykh you find must be Kamil. But even if you find a Kamil Shaykh, it does not mean you become a Murid Salih. And awliya Allah speak about it. What does it mean to be a Murid Salih? And they give one example and they say, if you understand this example, you will know what it means to be a Murid Salih. They said the example of a Murid is like the seed. Is like the seed. That's where he begins and that's where he ends. The seed has within itself the ability to come forth, sprout as a plant, become a tree, and bear fruit. But this does not happen overnight. This takes a lot of struggle, a lot of effort. So the very first thing this seed needs is land. Land in which it will be sown. This land is the land of your Shaykh. Once the seed is sowed in, it now needs water. And this water is the faizan of your Shaykh, which will water this seed. But in order for this seed to sprout, it must go underground. It must humble itself. And as long as the murid, being the seed, does not show humility, does not humble himself, does not pass through the states of fana, he can never sprout out. He must be humble. He must get rid of any claim that he may have, I'm an alim, or I am intelligent, or I am eloquent, or I have hifdul Quran, whatever claim it may be. The seed has to get rid of this claim and go down under. It must go down under in order for it to sprout out. And if the seed does go under and the faizan of the Kamil Shaykh is there, like the water and the sun and the environment, soon enough this seed will sprout. And after a period of time, this seed will become a tree. And this tree will bear fruit, and it will give shade, and it will benefit itself and others around it. It may be your family members, it may be the community, it may be the city. And this is how the awliya Allah judge a murid Salih. Is the murid sadiq in his tariq or is he not? The judgment is made as such, that does he come out at the end bearing fruits in order to guide people to Allah, for himself to be an embodiment of perfection. It's not necessary that you gain a title of Khalifa or Shaykh or Peer. No, this is not what I'm speaking about. You could be a Wali Allah and not have a title of a Shaykh, not have a title of a Khalifa. Having a title of a Khalifa, Shaykh, Peer is a larger responsibility. This is not what we aim for. You aim for purity with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you know, every wali that becomes a wali has to first become a murid.
Allah.